Now look, when in John 1:18 it says, no man of what? Read John 1:18. I've seen God at any time. The only begotten Son is in the bosom of the Father. John 1:18, 1 John 4:12. King James Bible.
No man has seen version. God at any time.
No man has seen God at any time. At what?
At any time.
Let's see if that statement is true. 1 John 4:12. Two places says no man has what?
No man has seen God at any time.
Alright. Get Matthew 5:8. Matthew 5:8.
Matthew 5:8.
Yeah.
Said, blessed are the pure in heart.
Blessed are the pure in heart.
King James Version.
Yeah.
For they shall see God.
What? So Yahshua can't lie. You want to call Jesus Christ, whose true name is Yahshua, he cannot lie. Cannot lie. You hear me? And he said, they blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall, according to the King James Version, it says they shall see God. Which is a false title, by the way. You see what I'm saying? But we just read that no man of what?
Seeing
God. Okay. Exodus 33:7. Exodus 24:9-12.
Isaiah 6:1. Exodus 24:9-12.
Yeah.
Then went up Moses and
Is Moses a man?
Yes.
Is Aaron a man?
Nadab.
Is he a man?
Mm-hmm.
So you have four men, plural, is that right? Plus 70. 74 men. And the Bible says, and they what?
And they saw the
God. Now why did we just read in John 1:18 that no man has seen God? Now we're reading that 74 men. You know, you see that there's a direct contradiction there?
Yeah.
You know why? Because they have taken away the true name, Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua, and gave us what? See, when they saw Yahweh, in some places they put just Lord. And then in some places they put Lord God. You understand? So you're not able to distinguish what it's really talking about. You understand? When we go read the whole name Bible and what was originally there, you're going to see that there's no contradiction when you use the true and correct name. It's very simple. See, read.
Exodus 33:11. King James.
I want 7.
Oh, verse 7.
Yeah.
And Moses took the tabernacle and pitched it without the camp and afar off from the camp.
Read.
And called it the meeting tent of the congregation.
Read.
And it came to pass that everyone which sought Yahweh or the Lord went out unto the meeting tent of the congregation which was.
Verse 11. Read.
And the Lord
spake unto Moses.
Moses face to face as a man speaketh unto his friend.
Well, hold on 1 second. If you are speaking to your face to face, wouldn't I see your face?
Quite so.
Say, the Bible says Moses speaking unto the Lord. And he spoke unto him what? Face to face. And you don't, and yet no man has seen.
And he turned again into the camp.
Read on.
But his servant, Joshua,
read.
The son of Nun, a young man, departed not out of the meeting tent.
Thank you. So now you find that. Why these contradictions? Again, because they took away the true name, Yahweh, and it was substituted for Lord. And in some places, Lord God. You understand? They took out Elohim, substitute that for God. Took out Yahshua, the name of the Holy Spirit, the Son of Yahweh, this Mashiach or Messiah, substituted for Jesus Christ. False names and titles, Jehovah. You understand? Now read the Holy Name Bible, you'll find that these contradictions will not be there. John 1:18, according to the Holy Name Bible, says, no man has seen the Father at any time. Read that to you. John 1:18. 1 John 4:12. Why? Because the Father, Yahweh, is what? Pure spirit. But they've seen Yahweh Elohim by divine what?
Vision.
Seen only in what? As the moderator said. Okay. There's enough in the moderation to see in the whole world.
Right.
Or to save souls. Seen only by what? Yahweh Elohim. Seen only what? It is impossible for you to see the Father in his pure spirit state. What does the moderator tell us? You understand? The moderator is really the first speaker. You understand what I'm saying? The moderator said he's what? Invisible, inscrutable, inconceivable in his original what? Pure spirit state of existence. Is that right? Now look, just like in this room here, don't you have water in the room? as vapor. Is that right?
Yeah.
How do you know the water is in the room? Where do you think it's come from? Is that right? Where did it come from? Right here in the room. Is that right? Now, if you enclose all of this here, enclose it, stop all the molds, and put an air conditioning unit in here. Is that right? And turn the air conditioner on. Then it's after a while, you start seeing what? Water, you know what I'm saying? Streaming down on the walls and all that stuff. Now where did the water come from? This is the same water that was in the room, but it was in a gaseous state, is that right? And then when you cool it down, a process called condensation, is that right? Cooling it down, it becomes water in a liquid state, and it takes on the shape and form of what? Any container that you put it in, like a glass or a bottle or so on and so forth, is that right? Cool it down further at 32 degrees what? Fahrenheit, or 0 degrees Celsius or centigrade, it becomes what? Solid. But it's but ice, liquid, and gas is the same water, H2O. Is that right?
Yes.
Is it a different water?
No.
But now, if I take a, if I go in the fridge and break up some ice, is that right? And throw it at you, that would hurt, wouldn't it?
Yes.
I'd rather somebody splash me with some water than hit me with a cube of ice. Is that right? But it's the same water, but it just transforms.
Different forms.
Different forms. So water exists in what? A gaseous state. Then it condescends and becomes water in a what? Liquid state. It takes on shape and form any container that it's put in. Cool it down further, it becomes what?
Solid ice.
Solid as ice. What's that talking about? It's talking about the Father. Oh, he exists. Yahweh, is that right? As pure spirit. Inscrutable, like the water in the room. Gas, is that right? It condescends, takes on shape and form any container you put it in, like the water in the bottle there, is that right? That's what they saw in divine what? Visions. You see what I'm saying? Then when this form here was, or the word was made what?
Flesh.
As Yahshua the Messiah, that's, now you can touch him, hand him, and see him, is that right? Just like the ice, is that right? And how do you spell the word ice?
I see.
Now you can see, touch it, and hand it. When it's in a gaseous state, you couldn't see it. Is that right?
Yeah.
You know what dry ice is?
Yes.
You ever seen dry ice, where it just, that just goes from solid to gas, is that right?
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? You know what dry ice is, and that burns, is that right? It's solidified what? CO2, carbon dioxide. That's how dry ice is, see? Anyways, so gas, liquid, and solid testifying to the Father, the Word, and the what? The Holy Spirit. These three are what? Are one. So when it says no man has seen the Father at any time, why? You cannot see the Father in his original pure spirit state. Why? He is inscrutable and what? Incomprehensible in that pure spirit state of existence. When he took on a superincomparable shape and form, that's only seen by divine what? Vision and understood in divine what? Revelation. Then this word here was made what? Flesh as Yahshua the Messiah. Word made flesh, John 1:1. In the beginning it was the what? The Word. That's not the Bible. Not the Bible, the Word. Yahweh Elohim, right? And the Word was what?
The Word was with Yahweh.
With Yahweh. And the Word was what?
The same was in the beginning with Yahweh.
14 says, and the Word was made what?
Flesh.
In other words, he created that old physical. Yahweh is pure spirit. Listen, the Father, is that right? In that pure spirit state of existence, the Father, Yahweh, took on what?
Shape and form.
A super incorporeal what? Shape and form. Then when that happened, that super incorporated shape and form created everything else. Is that right? The angel creation and the what? Physical creation. We are a part of the what? Physical creation. Who created this creation?
Yahweh.
The Word. In the beginning was the what? The Word. And the Word was with Yahweh. And the Word what? Was Yahweh. The same was in the beginning with Yahweh. All things were made by who?
Yahweh.
Him. Who's the Him? Yahweh Elohim. And this Word here was made what? Flesh took on a physical body or a suit of clothes, is that right? Walked around in his what? Own creation as Yahshua the Messiah. Very simple. You understand? And what did Yahshua do for us? He fulfilled the law and the prophets. He died, buried, and what?
Resurrected
for our what? Souls. And he does not want you to give the credit to Jesus Christ. Because in Isaiah 42:8, he said what?
I am Yahweh.
And what?
That is my name.
And what?
and my glory will I not give.
I'm going to share some of my glory, Jesus Christ.
No.
Right. Really? I'm going to share some of my glory, Henry, before I came up.
My glory.
Did you say that? And my glory will I what?
Not.
Yahweh is not going to share his glory with what?
Another.
Any idol. Is that right?
Neither.
My praise to what? Graven images. All right, let's run it boldly. Exodus 6, Exodus 3, verse 15. Exodus 6, 2 and 3.
Exodus 3, verse 15.
Yeah, read.
And then on him said, moreover unto Moses.
Read.
Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
I am Yahweh.
Yahweh.
Elohim of your father.
Elohim of your fathers. Elohim of Abraham.
Isaac, and Jacob. Read.
Elohim of Jacob.
Or Jacob,
and
read.
Sent me unto you.
This is my name, what?
Forever.
Forever. All that is forever. No beginning, no ending. Yahweh is the name forever. And my memorial unto what?
All generations.
Are we a generation on the face of the earth? So it's still Yahweh. You think it's a different Yahweh? Listen, when Yahweh devastated the land of Egypt, the Egyptians knew who Yahweh was then, didn't they? And then everywhere that Israel went, the Midianites, they knew who Yahweh was then. Is that right? And the people in Canaan's land, they heard who Yahweh was. Is that right? And he said in Exodus 9, verse 16, for in this cause have I raised thee up fear, to show thee my what? Power. And that my what?
Name.
Singular. Not names. God, I've sent it to a different name. It don't matter what you call it. But listen, it don't matter what you call it. Everything that you own, sign it over into my name then. You'd be a fool, is that right? Nobody does that. Names matter, is that right? And names have meaning. You understand? You know, somebody said to me, you know everybody with the name Damien has bad. You need to look at the name Damien when it means devil. You understand what I'm saying? Maybe you need to look at what the names mean before you give your child that name. You understand what I'm saying? Anyway, your name doesn't matter. The name that really matters is the name of the Savior. Keep reading. Get Psalm 68 and Psalm Exodus 6, 2 and 3, Psalm 68 and 4. Psalm 83, verse 17. Then get Matthew 1, verse 21, and John 5, 1.
Exodus 6 and verse 2.
Read.
And Elohim spake unto Moses and said unto him,
read.
I am Yahweh,
and I appeared unto
Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob
as what?
As El Shaddai.
El Shaddai. El means what? Almighty. Shaddai means what?
Provider.
Read.
But by my name,
Yahweh, was I what? Not known unto them. Is that right? The Patriarchs before, the new was El Shaddai, Psalm 68 and 4. Sing unto Elohim, sing praises to his name, extolling that right
upon him.
By his name what?
Yah,
not Jah. No J, no Jah. No J, no Jesus. No J, no Jehovah. Is that right? It's Yah, Yahweh, Hallelujah. Yah, Isaiah, Zechariah, Nehemiah, Zephaniah, Ezekiel, Daniel, Joel, Gospel, Angel, Michael, Gabriel. Yahshua, Yahweh is salvation, Yahweh is deliverer, is that right?
Yes.
You understand? Simple. I am come in my Father's name. You come in your Father's name, don't you? Is that right?
Yes.
And you receive me what?
Yes.
Not. Let another come. Like he said, let there be light, and there was light.
Yes.
The whole name Bible said, let another come in what? His own name, in the world, you will what?
Receive.
And the whole world have received what? Jesus Christ that came in his Father's name. There's no similarity here that did not come in his Father's name. Yeah, thank you, though. There's no similarity between Lord God and what?
Jesus
Christ. L is not a J, E is not a what? O, R is not a what? S, D is not a U. You understand what I'm saying? There is a similarity, by the way. They're fathers. That's what they have in common. What they have in common is that they're fathers and they're idols. 1 Chronicles 16, 26. Psalm 96 and verse 5. Let's work this thing. And then get Psalm 68 and 4. See? And listen, Yahweh took his name serious. You understand what I'm saying? Whosoever blasphemed the name Yahweh was what? Was killed. Isn't that serious? We're going to talk about that real quick.
1 Chronicles 16, 26.
1 Chronicles 16, 26.
For all of the gods of the people are idols.
Well, if it's spelled with a capital L-O-R-D, then you might have it. It's okay. Did it say that?
No. All the gods.
If it's spelled with capital G's, all right. All gods! Capital or common, uppercase or lowercase.
Right.
Or what? Idols, is that right? Psalm 96 and 5. All the gods of the what? The nation are idle. See,
Psalm 96,
6 and 5.
Verse 5.
Read.
For all the gods of the nations are idle.
Are idle, read.
But the Almighty made the heavens.
But Yahweh made the heavens and earth. Okay, get
Psalm 68 and 4. Sing unto Elohim. Sing praises to his name.
Read. And extol him that rideth upon the heavens.
By his name,
Not Jah. And rejoice before him. Psalm 72, 17.
Verse 17.
Yeah.
His name
shall endure.
Shall endure
forever.
His name shall be continued as long as the sun.
Not when King James chooses to change it to something else or by the translators. You understand? The name Yahweh shall continue and will continue even after the sun. Is that right? Because Yahweh El and Yahshua is the true sun. And look, get
Psalm 72, verse 17.
83, 16.
Psalm 82.
Read Psalm 83. Is it 72?
17.
72, 17. Read.
What was that?
Yeah, read 83 and 17. 16 and 17.
Yeah.
Psalm 82. Malachi 1 and 6.
Verse 16 and 17.
Yeah.
Fill their faces with shame, that they may seek thy name, O Yahweh. Let them be confounded and troubled forever.
That they know that thy name is.
And perish, that men may know. That thou, whose name
alone is Yahweh.
Is Yahweh,
and his name is
the Most High,
is the Most High. Read.
That's it.
Okay, thank you. Get Malachi 3 and 6. I am Yahweh and I want change now. I don't want Malachi 1 and 6 and 2 and 1.
For I am Yahweh and change not.
I am Yahweh and I want change sometimes. I change to your convenience. I am Yahweh and I want. It does not change. Mankind changes, all right?
Yeah.
Yahweh don't change. See, Malachi 1 and 6. Malachi 2
and 1 and 6. A
read.
Son honoreth his
son
father.
Son honoreth his father by covenant his name. Servant his master. Read.
If then I be a father, where is my honor?
Just like, you know, when you have a plantation of slaves, is that right? The man that owned the slave owner was smith, the slave were the smith slaves, is that right?
And if I be a master, where is my
honor? So on and so forth. You see? So they came in their master's name, or that's that son coming in his father's name. Matthew 1:21. She so shall bring
Malachi
forth.
Malachi 2, verse 1.
Malachi 2 and 1.
Now, O ye priests.
Yeah.
This commandment is for you.
Is for you.
If ye will not hear, and if ye will not lay to heart to give glory unto my name.
Say Yahweh.
Yahweh of hosts.
I will what?
Will even send a curse.
Curse upon you.
And I
Yahweh.
Will curse your
and look, this is a curse. You know that this is a curse? You didn't even know that when you go to church and the water baptized and eat the Lord's Supper and all that, that's a curse?
Yeah.
The Bible calls this a what? A curse. Is that right? And it says, cursing everyone that continue what? Not the law of things in the law to do them.
That's written in the book of the law.
The book of the law to do them. Get Matthew out.
Yeah, I've cursed them already because you not laid your heart.
Right. To give glory unto my name.
Is that what it says? Corrupt your seed.
Yeah, read.
And spread dung upon your faces, even the dung
of your son
and feast. And
okay.
One shall take you away with me.
Thank you. Matthew 1, verse 21. John 5, verse 43.
Matthew
Acts 4, 10 through 12.
And she shall bring forth
that's
a
Miriam.
Son.
That's Miriam. She shall bring forth a son.
Yeshua.
And thou shalt call his name
Yahshua.
Why? For he shall what? Save his. What does Shua mean? Hold on, 1 second there though. When you read that there, was there a colon there? Thou shalt call his name Yahshua.
Yes.
Was there a colon after Yahshua?
Yes.
In English, when you have a colon, Dr. Mitchell, what does that mean?
Something important follows after a colon.
Usually?
It means equals.
Or? An explanation.
Equivalent to our, an exponent.
Or an exponent. So, she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his
name
Yahshua. What does Yahshua mean? Yahweh is what? Salvation. For he shall save his people from their sins. Jesus can't save you from your sins.
No.
You understand? No matter what nice songs, you know, Jimmy Swaggart sing all over the world, right?
Yeah.
See, that's what these Christians, they're evangelists trying to capture people, is that right? Jesus is the sweetest name I know. That's why I want the world to know. Yeah, I know these guys, they can't read the sing, but they're singing a lie. Yahshua is the sweetest name. Is that right? That's why you should be singing, is that right? See? Matthew 5, verse, John 5, verse 43. I am what?
John 5:43. I am come in my Father's name.
Yahweh is the Father. Yah is the masculine portion. Weh is the what?
Feminine.
Yahshua is the Son. He came in the what? Masculine portion. Yahshua means what? Salvation. Is that simple?
Redeemed.
Yeah. Now get Philippians 2:9. Acts 4:10-12.
Ephesians 1:21. Be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel.
That by the name of what?
Yahshua
the Messiah of Nazareth, whom you crucified. Yahweh raised from the dead. Even by him doth this man stand here before you. Read.
Neither is there salvation
in any other. You listening? For there is none other. N-A-M-E, not names.
Under heaven.
Given among men. Whereby what? We must see. This is a family name. Ephesians 1:21. Far above what? All principalities and powers and might and dominion. And what? Every name that is named. Even Dr. Kittle's name. Is that right? This name Yahshua is above every name. That is name, even Jesus, is that right? Yeah. Not only in this world, but world to what?
Which is to come.
It doesn't need an explanation, does it? Still not, man. Loving it, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Listen, this is life or death, is that right? Proverbs 18:21. Death and life is in the what?
Power
of the tongue, and they that love it shall what? Listen, and we're tired of being lied to, is that right? You understand what I'm saying? See? Get Ephesians 1:21. Philippians 2:9, Acts 4:10-12. See? And the name, see?
Ephesians 1.
And 21.
21. Says, far above all principality.
You listening?
And power.
Are you listening? The name Yahshua is far above what?
All
principalities and power.
And power.
And might! And what?
And dominion.
And what? Every name.
That is name.
You leave what the Holy Spirit left on record? It is above what?
Every
name. That is what? Name. Not only
not
what?
Not only in this age, but also in that which is to come.
Jump down to the verse that says, of whom the whole family are in heaven.
Ephesians 2:14.
Thank you. 3:14. Of whom the whole what? Family. It's a family name, is that right?
For this cause.
Listen! It was Noah and his wife.
Family
that was saved, is that right? It was a family of fear, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And as it was in the days of what?
Noah.
Even so shall it be what? At the end of the world. So only the family of Yahshua, is that right? He is our husband. He is the head. We are his what? Body, is that right? You understand what I'm saying? You better be in this family or in this kingdom, is that right? You understand what I'm talking about? See, you can't imagine in a kingdom, you don't know what the king's name is.
That's
what's the name? You're in a kingdom. What's the name of the
kingdom?
I think it's Jesus. I think not. But that's false. I think it's Kinley. That's false! Is that right? Yahshua is the king, is that right?
Yes.
Read
his kingdom.
Matthew 5:17.
No. Ephesians 1:14.
For this cause, I bow my knees unto the Father of our Savior.
Yahshua!
Of
whom what?
The whole
what? Family! In heaven and earth.
His
what?
Name.
His name.
That he would grant you.
You know, not to kill us every time you come to class, treat it as your last class. Yahweh didn't have to wake you up this morning. Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So when you get a chance to be here, be here! Is that right?
Yeah.
Yahweh beating your heart, he doesn't have to do that, is that right? It's an involuntary function, is that right? Who's beating your heart? If you're beating your own heart, you'd have forgotten a long time ago, is that right? And your heart's beating Yahweh, is that right? So we have to give thanks to the one that gave us life, is that right?
Yes.
And we're not going to give any honor to idols, you see what I'm saying?
Hallelujah.
See, read. Far above all principalities and powers and might, that he may what?
His glory.
Read.
To be strengthened with might.
And don't be ashamed of it.
By his spirit.
Listen, not only when you're in the company of Yahshua's, you call on the name Yahweh and Yahshua. Because Yahshua said, if you are what? Ashamed of me before men, I'm going to what? If you deny me before men, I will deny you before the Father. It has happened before, where people, when they're in the company of friends, you don't want them to know you're calling the name of Yahweh. Don't be a hypocrite, is that right?
Right.
You speak the truth, is that right?
Yes.
The Father said, don't preach on your job. The man's not paying you to preach, is that right? You understand? He's paying you to work. You understand what I'm saying? But when you get a chance, you invite people, is that right?
That's
and this is life or death.
That's
you understand
right.
what I'm saying?
True.
This is not a joke, see?
That's right.
See, read on.
That he would grant
that he
you.
Would grant you what?
By the riches.
By the riches of his mind.
To be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man.
Okay.
That Yahshua the Messiah may dwell in your hearts by faith.
4:10 to
that
return.
He, Acts. Being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all his sons.
Acts 4:10.
Yeah. And length, and depth, and height, and to know the love of Yahshua the Messiah which passeth knowledge.
Acts.
That he might be filled with all the fullness of Yahweh.
Philippians
4:9. He may be filled with all the fullness of Yahweh. It doesn't mean that you're the fullness.
Right.
You understand? Sure. Listen, and Dr. Kill is not the fullness.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? The word fullness is mentioned 4 or 5 times in the book. And none of them is accredited to Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley. There's only one fullness, and that's Yahshua, is that right? Fullness means the creator. You can receive of the fullness. What does of mean, Dr.?
Some of it.
The right to the major, you're a linguist.
A portion.
A portion of.
Yeah.
Portion of. Yes, sir. Right. Inside the right here. Nice to have a guy like that, right? That's
right.
It's a component of. Does that make you the fullness?
A renegade.
Is that right?
That he might be
filled with all the what?
Yahshua.
Yahshua is the fullness. Is that right? One fullness. You see what I'm saying? And you defend the truth all the way down to the end. You see what I'm saying? See? But alright, anyways, read on.
Philippians 2:9.
Wherefore Yahweh lied exalted. Elohim. And I've given Elohim a what?
A name. A name. Which is above
a name. A name. Which is above what?
Every name.
That had the name of Yahshua. Sure, is that right?
Every knee
shall bow, every tongue shall
confess. Things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth.
Now imagine you're in the kingdom of Yahshua and you don't know what the king's name is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all right, read Matthew 6:10. Where it says, thy kingdom come. You know what they asked him when you pray?
Yeah, Matthew 6.
They said, Matthew 6:10.
And 10. All right, thy kingdom come.
Read 9.
Verse 9. After this matter, therefore, pray ye, our Father.
They asked Yahshua, how should we pray? And they said, that our Father. He said, our Father.
Who art in heaven. Hallowed.
What does hallowed mean?
Holy
be thy name. So why are you not using it then? You love to pray that prayer, right? Why are you using the name then? If hallowed or holy be thy name. Read. Verse.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will
whoa,
be
whoa, whoa, whoa. Thy kingdom what?
Come.
Look at this chart. It says present what?
Kingdom
means. Is that right? Now look. You can't pray that prayer now.
Right.
The king. One second. Matthew 16:28.
Matthew 16:28. Verily I say unto you, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see a vision of the Son of Man's coming, kingdom and glory.
Did you hear what she just said?
Mm-hmm.
She said, Yahshua speaking. He said, there shall be some standing here which shall not taste of what?
Death.
Until they see a vision of the Son of Man coming in his what?
Glory.
Hold on then. So the kingdom didn't come yet. You'd have to have men that are 2,000 years old.
Right, they would have still be alive.
Because he says, over 2,000 years old. Because he said, there shall be what? Some what? Standing here which shall not what?
Taste
of death. Until what? Because I read John 14:3, it says, I go to prepare a place for you. Yahshua wasn't preparing any kingdom. How do we know that? Matthew 25:34. Because the kingdom was already what?
Prepared
what? Before the what? Foundation of the world. But these liars and hypocrites call themselves Christians, saying that Jesus Christ is gone off to build a kingdom in the sky, and he's going to come back and kick over tombstones. Is that right? And take us up in heaven, and we're going to walk streets of glory and sing redemption story. And garbage, is that right? You understand? We're going to drink milk and honey, is that right? The corn and the bees are on earth, is that right? It's ridiculous. You understand? There shall be some standing here that shall. Matthew 25:34. Now if you're in the kingdom of Yahshua, you should know what the name of the king is.
Yes,
then
shall the king say unto them on his right
hand. On his right hand, read.
Come ye,
blessed of my Father.
Inherit
the kingdom.
Prepared for you. From the foundation of the world.
Oh, really?
Yes.
So with that lead, that wrote Matthew 25:1. 34 right here. Make sure you read that. The kingdom was already what?
Prepared.
Before the what?
Foundation.
So when it says, I go to prepare a place for you, obviously, that's not the kingdom. So what was Yahshua preparing? His death, burial, and what?
Resurrection
prepared a way to the kingdom. Is that right? John 14:6. I am the what?
Way.
The truth and the what?
Right.
He ain't prepared no kingdom. No man has ascended up to heaven. He that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man, who is where?
In heaven.
Read it.
John 3:13.
Read. Thank you. No man.
No.
John 3:13. And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven.
Read that again.
And no man hath ascended up to heaven. But he that came down from heaven.
What? It says, no man hath what, Dr. Reed?
Ascended up
to what?
Heaven.
No man, is that right?
No man.
Is Yahshua lying?
No.
Then you don't read that. Elijah went up in a chariot to find him. So I never see Elijah up there. You don't read that. Enoch was translating. I never see Enoch up there. And so heaven is not a Jacob. Exodus. The body of heaven in his what? Clearness, is that right? So when he was manifested in the flesh, even the Son of Man, which is where? In heaven. So when he's on earth, in a physical body, or out of a physical body, that is heaven, is that right? And he said, I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, not where I'm going, or where I will be, is that right? Where I what? Am, there you may be also. Where was he?
In heaven.
Yeah, that's in heaven, is that right? That's the Holy Spirit manifested in the flesh, is that right?
Yes.
So if you accept Yahshua in your heart and mind, that puts you in heaven. You understand what I'm talking about? You understand what I'm saying? Colossians 1:30. He hath what? Translated us. Delivered us from the what? Power of what?
Darkness.
And hath what? Translated us into the what? Kingdom of his dear son. Now how do you do that? Matthew 24:15, is that right? And this gospel of the what? Kingdom, is that right? So now, the death, burial, resurrection of Yahshua the Messiah, blood, water, spirit, you understand? That's what translates you into the kingdom. Very simple. Look at it. And then here, where do we live? Present. Kingdom what?
Ish.
What's the difference? Receive it. It's a gift. It's a present. It's current. Is that right? And then listen. Why is it? What's the difference? For age, present, kingdom age. There's an availability to receive the Holy Spirit in this age. Is that right? In the kingdom on earth. Colossians 1:13.
Colossians 1:13.
12:10. Revelation.
Giving thanks unto the Father.
Giving thanks to the Father.
Which hath made us meet or suitable.
Yeah.
Partakers of the inheritance of the sons in light.
In light, read.
Who hath delivered us
from the power of what?
Darkness.
Listen, this is darkness. Ignorance of your creator is what? Darkness.
Yes.
Check the chart here. Everything down here was what?
Black.
Darkness, is that right? Fourth day of creation, what happened?
Created the sun, moon, and star.
Why? You understand? The sun, light. And the what? That's the physical light of the world. Is that right? Yahshua the Messiah is the what?
True.
The light of the world. So I'm saying, everybody else was in what? From the fall of Adam.
Darkness.
Is that right? You follow me? Death reigned from what? Adam. To Moses. Even over them that what? Act that sin. So now how do we get in the kingdom? Picked up by Jesus Christ. You gotta be kidding me. Is that right? What translates you into the kingdom? 13. Colossians 1:13. Yes.
It said, who has delivered us?
Who?
Yahshua.
Who has delivered us? From the power of what?
Dark.
Dark. darkness, is that right?
And hath
ignorance, is that right? And hath translated us
into the kingdom.
Into the what?
Dear son.
Kingdom. Hold on. You know why I said the kingdom don't come yet? Matthew 12, 28. Then get the gospel of the kingdom, but that's where we're going next. Real quick.
Matthew 12 and verse 28.
Yeah.
But if I cast out demons.
Yahshua said, if I cast out what? Demons. By the Spirit of Yahweh. Read.
Then the kingdom of Yahweh.
Then the kingdom of Yahweh is what?
Come unto you.
Is what? Is. Present tense. 2,000 years ago. Is. You listening to the words? Come. You know why I said the kingdom don't come in? Because the demons are cast out yet.
Right.
Are you with me?
Yes.
You understand? Michael 12, 20. When the demons are what? Cast out. How do you cast them out that? Carry them and make them. Wake them up in church.
No.
Get them a bath and a woman.
No.
So you need to preach the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. Is that right? Yeah. Cast them demons out. Is that right? And that would say, when the true gospel is being preached, you better be in the right frame of mind. Because them Satan spirits, they're going around lurking, is that right? You think about the rice and peas, think about Monday morning, is that right? He said, can I get into it? Yeah, we said, go ahead, is that right? Right in your soul, is that right? And the first thing of that mind is what?
First
and what? That's why it's a spiritual operation. You better be in the right frame of mind. When you come to class, this is life or death. It's not a joke. You understand? See? And the only way that one can be translated is Revelation 12 and 10 and 11. See? Revelation 12 and 10.
And the great dragon was cast out, the old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole
world. It's the same thing, you
know?
After Satan is cast out, then cometh the what?
Kingdom.
The kingdom, is that right? Read.
I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now come salvation
and strength,
and the kingdom of our enemies.
What does kingdom mean? Really? Kingdom means, is that right? Now has come salvation and strength, and the power of his Messiah. The accuser of the brethren is what? Cast down, is that right?
Yep.
Listen, you better be careful you're talking about people of Yahweh. You understand?
True.
And they said, listen, and they said, when do we talk bad about you? Do we feed this and do that and do this? Depart from me, yeah. You workers of what? Iniquity. I know you not. Is that right? You see what I'm saying? He said, when did we do this, Yahshua? We done all this in your name. You do it to one of these what? Little one, you do it to me.
Then shall the righteous answer and say,
yeah. Read, Rabbi, teacher.
Matthew 25.
Yeah.
Verse 37.
37. Read,
Rabbi,
teacher.
When saw we thee hungry and fed thee?
Yeah.
Or thirsty and gave thee drink? When saw we thee a stranger unto thee?
Teacher, do you love me?
Or naked?
Feed thy what?
And clothe thee.
Sheep. Read.
Verse 40. And the king shall answer and say unto them.
Yeah.
Verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it
unto my brethren. Do we need all these people and teach them birds some doctrine and water baptize them and teach them that doctrine is name and savior? Yeah. Do we need all these things? Is that right? Depart from me, ye workers of what? Iniquity. Imagine you receive the true gospel of the kingdom, you turn it back unto it. Don't you turn it back unto life, is that right? See what I'm saying?
Matthew 25, verse 40, continue.
Read.
Verily I say unto you.
Truly, verily means truly, right? Read.
Inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of my brethren, ye have done it unto me.
That's for our kingdom. Exodus 19 and 6. Daniel 2, 44 and 45. Matthew 3 and 2, is that right? The kingdom of heaven is what? At hand, is that right? So I'm saying Luke 19 and 6. I mean, Exodus 19 and 6. Yahweh said a kingdom of what? Priests, is that right? Who is Yahshua? He's the king and what? High priest, is that right? Not after the order of what? Aaron, but after the order of who? Melchizedek, is that right? King of Salem, is that right? Prince of peace, is that right? King of peace. Read on. You shall be a kingdom of what?
Be unto me a kingdom of
priests
and an holy nation.
Holy nation. Daniel 2:44.
These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel.
Thank you. Daniel 2:44. Read.
And in the days of
law and prophets, is that right? Fulfillment. Law, prophecy, fulfillment. The days of Reed?
These kings?
Yeah.
Shall the Elohim of heaven set up a kingdom?
Which kings? Four satanic kingdoms, is that right? Babylon, is that right? You listening? Media Persia, Greece and what? Rule.
Set up a kingdom.
Poor, is that right? Wife is the what? England, is that right?
Yeah.
America, king of the north, is that right?
Yeah.
Russia is the beard, is that right?
Yeah.
The days of these kings shall the Elohim of heaven set up a kingdom. A kingdom
which shall never be destroyed.
Why? Because it's not physical.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Listen, you will let the headquarters. Oh yeah. My goodness. If you're around 10 people in your school, you can't be a clerk. I know I'm online. You need to hear this too. So no one could be a school because you only had 8. If you don't
so we're towards here gathered in my
read.
Yeah. But it shall break in pieces and consume all these
kingdoms. All these kingdoms.
And shall stand forever.
So the death, burial, resurrection of Yahshua the Messiah. Broke down what? The kingdoms of what?
God.
Satan, is that right?
Yeah.
Abolished, is that right?
Yeah.
Is that what? Where's the chart? King, yeah, here we go. Is that right? Here it is. Kingdom of Satan, what? Abolished. Kingdom of Yahshua, what? Established through his death, burial, resurrection, is that right? That's why it's called the gospel of the kingdom. Because that's what puts you into the kingdom of his dear son. Is that right? And hath what? Translated us into the what?
Kingdom.
Now will translate us. Is that right? You understand? Hath delivered us from the power of what?
Darkness.
Is that right? What can do that but the precious blood of Yahshua? Read.
Daniel, chapter 2, verse 45, continue. For as much as thou sawest that the stone was cut out of the mountain without hands.
Without hands, read.
And that it break in pieces, the iron, the bread, brass, the clay,
all right,
the
stop.
Silver.
Thank you. Matthew 3 and 2.
Matthew 3
and 2.
And
2. Luke 17, 20.
And say, repent.
Luke 17, 20. King James. And he said, repent ye. That's John the Baptist. Why?
The kingdom of heaven is near at hand.
That, see a man here? Where's your hand, Doc?
Hand, right here.
That's pretty close.
Mm-hmm.
But if the kingdom is in the sky, that's far.
Yes.
But here John says, the kingdom is at what?
Sharp.
Near.
Near. Is that right? Yeah. And you see all, you understand 1656? 8 bones in the wrist, is that right? 8 souls saved in the what? Ark! Scaphoid bone, both shaped, is that right? Two bones here, only in the what?
Radius.
What does radius mean? Rod! What's the tabernacle? A rod! Reed like unto her. Can you see the rod here? Give it here. And then elbow, where did Yahshua die? He's elbow. Where do you draw blood from?
Right here.
Why? Because Yahshua shed his blood right there, is that right? Then his death, burial, resurrection, ascension, poured out that Holy Spirit. Be one. Bone is spelled B-O-N-E. Be one. In Yahshua the Messiah. It goes into the body. Is that what I'm saying? Yahweh. Mercy, is that right? The Father, is that right? Read up. Luke 17 and 20, read with.
Yes.
And get Matthew 24, 15. Gospel of the kingdom. Let's preach the gospel.
Luke 17, verse 20.
17, 20. Read.
And when he was demanded of the Pharisees.
When he was what, Dr. Mitchell?
Demanded.
Hold on. If I said to this young lady, may I borrow your pen? I asked you for the pen.
Request.
It's a request, is that right? But if I demand the pen, give me the pen!
Absolutely.
That's your name.
It's a big difference, right?
Absolutely.
I said, you're right, don't fix this, alright?
I have joking.
Is that right? That's how bad they wanted to know! When he was what? Demanding!
Demanding.
When he demands, you really want to know. Is that right?
Exactly.
Read.
Of the Pharisees.
Of the Pharisees.
When the kingdom of Yahweh Elohim should come.
Yeah.
He answered them and said,
mm-hmm.
The kingdom of Yahweh Elohim cometh not with observation.
It's a good thing because 75 people get deported. 75 Jamaicans get deported on Thursday from Louisiana. You heard that on the news?
Nope.
Yes.
Yeah, I walk around and look for illegal people and fling them out of America, not true? Yeah? People run off long time, trying to get themselves sorted out. Time catch upon them, you know what I'm saying? They get comfortable, deport them. No, it's good. It's not Los Angeles, California.
Yeah.
Can't have a visa. Yes, I'm read.
Yeah.
So the kingdom, in other words, what I'm trying to say. What I'm saying is, the kingdom is not geographical.
Yeah.
When they already mind it. I'm a Pharisee. Read.
Luke 17, verse 21.
Mm-hmm.
Neither shall they say, Lo here, or Lo there,
oh,
or behold.
What?
The kingdom of Yahweh is within you.
So it's not over there in Addis Ababa.
No.
It's not in Mecca.
No.
It's not in the sky.
No.
It's not in LA.
No.
And it's not Dr. Killing is the king.
No.
You need Killing, but he's not the king. Yahshua, is that right?
That's right.
Read.
It's within you.
Is the kingdom is where?
Inside of you.
Where?
Within you.
You sure you read that right?
So
read hold it, man. Read hold it, man. When he was demanded, he said, the kingdom of Yahweh cometh not with what? You can't observe it. Say, why? Because it's not physical. Another thing he said, Matthew 8 and 20. Foxes are what?
Oh,
and birds are what?
Yes.
But the Son of Man are what?
No,
he never has a yard. He never has a house. That's true.
Right.
He just walk around and say, he never has a yard. Is that right? In other words, so therefore, when he died, buried and what?
Resurrected.
Poured out the Holy Spirit. Where did he lay his head? In the what? Hearts and what? Minds of mankind. Under them what? Is that right?
And
that's where he laid his head. King in his kingdom. What does kingdom mean?
Dominion of the king or queen.
King's domain. Thank you. Dominion of the king.
Or queen.
Or queen. In this case, king.
Yeah. That's it. Matthew chapter 8.
Why Jesus going to get a kingdom?
No, he's a bastard.
Why Dr. Keeley couldn't get a kingdom?
No,
he was not the first one.
not the same. So Daniel 9, in the old days said, this kingdom is not what? Up for success. You can't succeed.
No.
You know why? Because he's not dead.
Without a successor.
Exactly. Yahshua's kingdom is not up for succession. Read.
Yes. Matthew 8, verse 20.
Yes.
And Yahshua said,
then get the gospel of the kingdom. Matthew 24, 15.
The foxes have holes, and the birds of the air have nests.
Yeah.
But the Son of Man hath not where to lay his head. And another of his disciples said unto him, Rabbi, suffer me first to go and bury my father.
Thank you. That's good. So where did he lay his head? After his death, burial, and what? Resurrection. He did what? Lay his head into the hearts and minds of mankind on the day of Pentecost. Get the gospel of the kingdom. 5 minutes.
Matthew 24,
15.
When ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation.
14, I'm sorry.
And the glad tidings.
And the read the other version. Glad tidings, good news, gospel, is that right?
And this gospel.
That's why it's the gospel of the kingdom. What is the gospel? Gospel music, it sounds good, is that right?
No.
Jesus is the
resurrection.
It's the death, burial, and what?
Resurrection.
Blood, water, spirit.
40.
40. In the name of Yahshua, is that right?
You
can't run for 5 minutes. Of course, you can't run for 5 minutes. First day of creation. Earth was now what? Form, void, is that right? Death like spirit. Testifying to the death of Yahshua. Buried on the second day. Third day, the waters what? Rolled back. Dry land appeared. Seed of what? Vegetation sprang forth. Is that right?
Yes.
What happened on the fourth day? Sun, moon, and what?